Well, hello and welcome to each and every one of you. It's so wonderful to see you or to see your names, to feel your presence and to be with you here today in the light of our Lord. And so my name is Dr. Gold and I serve as one of the head reverends of Astara. And this is Astara's meditation and mindfulness. And so today we will open, as we open traditionally, with a prayer found in Astara's Book of Life, First Degree, Lesson 1. And we will invoke the great architect of the universe. May I be a channel through which thy holy ones approach the world. May I be centered in the radiation of thy power. Teach me to travel light, that I may better gain the heights. Break the bonds that bind. Teach me to give of myself entirely to thy service, to attune myself to thy will. Teach me to lay down the small personal life for the greater cosmic life, and to love with the love of God. To those of you that are just joining, welcome, welcome. We did an invocation. You are welcome to invoke and become more in tune with the divine and the Astarian hierarchy here today. And so today is a special day. Actually, we're in a special time of the year. And so we have Passover coming. And after that, we have Easter coming. And these are holidays of great avatars that came down. Later, we have Wesak coming. Also holidays of great, those are Mahavatars, great, great avatars that come down. And so we have here today the beginning of the celebration of Passover. And so Passover, not to get into the story of Passover, right? But this is a holiday of what? This is a holiday of Moses, the great avatar Moses. And this is a holiday of liberation. It's a holiday of liberation. It's a holiday of sacrifice. It's a holiday of liberation. And so in the Christian tradition, there's a very famous painting, many paintings of the Last Supper, right? The Last Supper. The Last Supper included Jesus, his disciples, and that was actually them. What supper were they having? Well, they were having something called Pesach. Pesach is a Hebrew word, and it is the meal that occurs on Passover evening, okay? And so that is actually, Jesus was a rabbi, and he was leading the Passover service. And so today we will do a breath of Moses. We will do a breath of Moses. So as we were on breathing techniques, there is actually, so Moses is called the lawgiver, actually. So what did he do? He liberated, right? He led people through a desert. He founded a holy land, right? Mount Sinai, a holy mountain, which was metaphorical of both him ascending the mountain literally, and both him going in and ascending the mountain or the ladder of the chakras, right? Internally. So there's an inner and an outer meaning, an exoteric and an esoteric meaning to all of these parables and stories and metaphors. So Moses is known as the lawgiver, and he also gave the law of breath. And Moses taught many different types of breathing cycles. And one of the breathing cycles he taught actually was, guess what? The cosmic breath, right? The cosmic rhythm that we did a couple weeks ago. And so Moses also taught the 7171 breath, and it is found in the teachings of Moses, and it is found in the Kabbalah. It is found in the Kabbalah. Now, the Kabbalah is to Judaism. Kabbalah is like the esoteric teachings of Judaism. Most religions have an esoteric, they have an exoteric, which are like outer traditions and rituals. And then they have the esoteric, which are inner traditions and rituals. So the Jewish religion has the Kabbalah, right? And these are the esoteric teachings of divine truth, okay? So the Muslim religion, they have what's called the Sufi tradition. And these are the esoteric teachings, the inner teachings of divine truth, okay? Now, in various forms of yoga, there are actually degrees of esoteric mysticism. And the most esoteric, like of the esoteric forms of yoga or yoga, also called Sanatana Dharma, the most esoteric of those is called the Nath tradition, N-A-T-H, the Nath tradition of yogis. And then a brother to that on the same branch is called the Akowal tradition, the Akowal tradition, okay? So those come from Lord Shiva himself, Mahadev, and also Matsyendranath. Matsyendranath was a direct disciple of Lord Shiva, if you could imagine. Okay, and so what we have here today is we will be practicing the cosmic rhythm in honor of Moses, as he was one of the teachers of the cosmic rhythm breath. 3,500 years ago, give or take. If somebody wants to correct me on that, that's fine. This happened approximately 3,500 years ago. And so if you know the exact date, good for you, first of all. And let us all know. Okay. And so in Astara's Book of Life, Erlene writes, the cosmic rhythm in Astara's Book of Life, 6th degree, lesson 21, quote, you can become a greater part of that cosmic rhythm and body by becoming in tune with the rhythm of your own body. The secret of this achievement is through rhythmic breathing. The cosmic rhythmic breathing of our Earth Mother is 7-1-7-1. That is, to harmonize with the rhythmic breathing of our world requires an inhalation of 7 counts, a hold, an exhalation of 7 counts, a hold. In whatever breath discipline you are involved, this count will always attune you to the natural breathing rhythm of the planet. In whatever breath discipline you are involved, this count, 7-1, will always attune you, the body, and your consciousness to the natural breathing rhythm of the planet, of this globe, of this earth. So today, in honor of the great avatar and lawgiver, Moses, we will practice the cosmic rhythmic breathing of our Mother Earth. And so today, when we do the Astarian affirmation, we will be doing it with the name of Moses, with the name of Moses. So there are subtle differences, right? So avatars, avatar is composed of two words. It's highly misunderstood in both the East and the West. People don't understand what it is. That's because they lost or they don't study the original teachings, right? So avatar means downward crossing. That's what avatar means. It's a descent of divinity and it's a crossing over into the terrestrial plane. Avatars are such great beings that they cannot compose a physical body of carbon molecules like you or I do, right? They actually have to take on karma of their disciples to materialize a physical body, right? Because they don't have the karma to have a terrestrial body. This plane is a terrestrial plane, right? Earth plane, okay? So they take on karma of their disciples to create a terrestrial body. And then they are in form. Their avatars are a divine blessing from the Lord, but also rare. Rare. Okay. Now there, that doesn't mean that like they only incarnate every 5,000 years. Like, that's not true. That's not true at all. A lot of times they're here. A lot of times they're incognito, things like this, but there aren't like millions of them walking around on the planet. And just because people say they're avatars, we want to have direct experiences of them. And so if they light shines on them and they cast no shadow, then at times they may cast no shadow. They may be, that is one test of an avatar. They have no karma, so they're not bound by the duality of light and dark. If they're not bound by duality, they have no light and dark. Thereby, when the light shines on them, when they want, they can cast no shadow. Now, sometimes they do because they don't want to draw attention, right? But they can cast no shadow. This is in the ancient text. You can also find it in Paramahansa Yogananda's Autobiography of a Yogi. The other test for an avatar, now don't go around testing people. It's not very nice to test the master. But the other test, right, that can happen is you can bow, you can pranam, which is when you get on your hands and knees and pranam. And when you touch their feet, because their body is actually composed of other earthly light, light not from the earth, okay, light not necessarily from Lord Surya, our sun, other light, you can go, these are feet, this is not feet, this is my hand, but if these represented feet, right, and I went to pranam and touch the feet, my hands, if they chose, could go straight through the feet and touch the ground, because their bodies is composed of other earthly light. So these are some tests, right, that happen, and they are gifts. When somebody experiences these types of gifts, these types of experiences, this is a divine blessing. You have to earn it. A person can't just go up critically demanding proof, right? So these types of divine experiences, they're real, but a person earns it karmically, and such is a tremendous blessing, right? Such is a tremendous, tremendous blessing. If you've been in the presence of an avatar in this incarnation, you are tremendously blessed. And I may recommend giving internal gratitude at this point in time. Okay. Now, today, we will do the 7-1-7-1 breath in honor of Moses. Okay. Let's see here. Oh, I'm going to pull up our Astara emblem. So you don't need to look at me while we meditate. There we go. Okay. I didn't have that prepared before. My apologies. And so we'll be able to look at the Astara emblem. Share screen. Here we go. Okay. So now, if you remember the 7-1-7-1 breath, how many parts? That was a little premature. How many parts does the breath have? Right? There's four parts. Okay. We have the inhale, the hold, the exhale, and the hold. Oh, good. People remember the inhale, the hold, the exhale, and the hold. Inhale, hold, exhale, hold. Four parts to the breath. Okay. So 7-1-7-1 means we inhale for 7. Hold for 7, exhale for 7, hold for 7, and we will repeat that, okay? So, what we're gonna do first What we'll do first is we're going to prepare, okay? So we're going to inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Okay. Now we're going to perform a 7-1-7 breath three times. We'll perform a 7-1-7-1 breath three times. Okay. So we're going to inhale and exhale. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold. Relax. Close your eyes. I am surrounded by the pure white light of Moses. Only good shall come to me. Only good shall go from me. I give thanks. I give thanks. I give thanks. I am surrounded by the pure white light of Moses. Only good shall come to me. Only good shall go from me. I give thanks. I give thanks. I give thanks. Open your eyes. We'll perform 6 breathing cycles. We'll perform 6 7-1 breathing cycles. Okay. So we're going to inhale and exhale. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, five, six, seven, hold. Close your eyes. Put your awareness on your heart. I am surrounded by the pure white light of Moses. Only good shall come to me. Only good shall go from me. I give thanks. I give thanks. I give thanks. I am surrounded by the pure white light of Moses. Only good shall come to me. Only good shall go from me. I give thanks. I give thanks. I give thanks. Be aware of your heart. Open your eyes. Okay. We will do 9 breathing cycles. 9 breathing cycles of 7-1. 7-1. Okay. So if you want to focus somewhere while you're doing your breathing cycles, focus on your heart. My heart's a little lower, but my hand goes out of the screen. Focus on your heart. Okay. So. I'll count for the first 3. And then afterwards, I will not do the counts. I'll just say the numbers. So the first time I'll say, inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hold. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hold. I'll do that 3 times. And then I will just say, inhale, hold, exhale, hold. Okay. And there'll be more silence. There'll be more silence. You can go deeper. Focus on your heart as you breathe. Okay, so we're going to inhale and exhale. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hold. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hold. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hold. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hold. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hold. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hold. Inhale. Hold. Exhale. Hold. Inhale, hold, exhale, hold, inhale, hold, exhale, hold, inhale. Hold, exhale, hold, inhale, hold, exhale. Hold, inhale, hold, exhale, hold. Close your eyes, be aware of your heart, be aware of your heart. I am surrounded by the pure white light of Moses. Only good can come to me. Only good shall go from me. I give thanks. I give thanks. I give thanks. I am surrounded by the pure white light of all. Only good shall come to me. Only good shall go from me. I give thanks. I give thanks. I give thanks. deeply. Keep your eyes closed. Slowly come back to your body. Come back to your body and focus on your navel. Focus on the umbilicus or the navel. Focus on the soles of your feet. Focus on the soles of your feet. Be aware of the center of the earth. Be aware of the liquid gold center of the earth. May all excess prana and unabsorbed blessings go down into the center of the earth. May all excess prana and unabsorbed blessings go down into the center of the planetary logos. May all excess prana and unabsorbed blessings go down into the center of the planetary disciple. Slowly, slowly, open your eyes. Slowly, slowly, come back to your body. Move your arms and move your legs. How are you doing? You can enter into the chat how you're doing. We would love to hear from you. We would love to hear from you. Okay. So this is an advanced cosmic rhythm breathing 7171 with the stars affirmation invocation to Moses, right? On the anniversary, when Moses incarnated on the planet, when Moses was walking on the planet. And so as we do things in cosmic order, which means in cycle, because everything is a cycle, time is a circle. It's not linear, it's a circle. Got a circle here. This is a circle, right? It's like.
That was easy.
Okay, so this is a circle, okay? So time is a cyclical, it's cyclical, right? And so then as time comes back around to the time when that avatar was on the planet here, right? Then it's more easy to be in tune with that avatar. It's more easy to be in tune with that avatar, okay? So today it felt like a short meditation, but profound. Yes. And so as we tune ourselves to the frequency, which means the qualitative and quantitative tone, as we tune ourselves to the frequency of the avatar, it is very profound, very profound. And what is it profound on? It's profound on our consciousness. It's profound on our consciousness. Now, you may have physical, emotional, mental health or well-being or healing as a result of your attunement, because the physical, emotional, mental bodies follow your consciousness. They follow your consciousness. So when you have profound experiences on your consciousness, the others will follow suit. The others will follow suit. So this was short and sweet. You can do the 7-1 breath. Is very energizing, by the way. If you need more energy, you can do the 7-1-7-1 breath. And you can invoke to Moses. And this will be celebrated, I think, beginning Saturday for the next 8 days. Okay. Now, next week, Thursday will be the day before Good Friday. And so we will have a special ceremony next week to the avatar Christ, to the avatar Christ, okay? And so throughout the calendar year, we will work on attuning our consciousness according to the rhythmic calendar and when the avatars and the great ones walked on the planet, okay? So we love you. We thank you. Have a wonderful, wonderful practice. And we will see you here next week. Thank you. Thank you. May you be blessed with the pure white light.